Hello, I'm Eric Garloff, your host for Walking with Jesus. History often remembers people for what they have accomplished in their lives. To gain a greater insight into the life of an individual, we often study what they stood for, what kind of character they possessed, what impact they had on society and in the world, etc. So it is with God also. Today, in episode number 10, we're going to be talking about gaining a knowledge of God. In past programs, we have mentioned that God's fingerprints, so to speak, can be seen in the things He has created. Studying His creation, then, becomes one of the ways we can gain a deeper knowledge of God Himself. As we do this, we learn of His infinite wisdom and power. We experience something of His endless love for humanity, as He prepared a world of infinite marvels and beauty for us to enjoy. The unsearchable secrets of the universe lie with Him, as He has created and ordained all things that are and all things that will ever be. All nature, whether found on land or in the sea or in the heavens above, testify and proclaim something about the God of creation. This is just one of the many avenues in which a person can experience God and gain a knowledge of Him. Before I continue, however, I'd like to point out one thing. Every man, woman, and child would do well to keep an open mind about the existence of God. You see, many have already made up their minds and claim that there is no God, but this is a reckless and irresponsible path to follow. Here's what I mean by that. If a person assumes there is no God, and he or she lives their life according to that belief, and then finds out at the end of time that God really does exist, then that person has forfeited their eternal life because they rejected the only one who could save them from eternal death. On the other hand, what could you possibly lose by believing in Jesus as the Savior of the world and by following Him in doing good for others? Friends, there's absolutely nothing to lose, but I tell you today, there's everything to gain. A second avenue that you can examine to gain a knowledge of God is to study the miracles found in the historical writings of the Bible. For example, just recently I saw a story floating around on the internet where the scientists claim that they can explain the parting of the Red Sea. Now, they said that a constant wind blowing at 65 to 67 miles per hour would be enough to hold back the water at a certain location of the Red Sea. This would then permit the children of Israel to walk over to the other side. Now, the people who were saying this did not believe in the miracle which God had performed at the Red Sea. They were trying to find a scientific explanation to eliminate God from the equation. However, when you study the biblical account, you will notice things which cannot be answered by the scientific explanation that was proposed. One such detail, which the scientists admitted in this article themselves, is the fact that the Bible account states the children of Israel walked through the parted sea, which had a wall of water on both sides, on their left and on their right. You see, my friend, when God works a miracle, there is no human explanation for it. In the case the scientists proposed, the water would have only formed a wall of water upstream from them. The downstream water would have all flowed away, and the rest of the seabed downstream from them would have been emptied as the water would have continued to flow away. The scientists' explanation would have had some really unbelievable timing attached to it as well, as the biblical account said that God parted the sea to provide the children of Israel an escape route from the pursuing Egyptian army. Not only that, but the sea only remained parted long enough for the Israelites to safely pass through, after which the sea closed up again, just in time to swallow up the whole Egyptian army that had entered the sea in pursuit of the Israelites. Yes, my friend, there is just too much coincidence here, don't you think? Too many orchestrated events of timing to actually think this was a freak of nature, a thing of chance, something which just happened at the right time, and for the exact length of time needed to accomplish their escape and the destruction of the Egyptian army. There are at least three other avenues which can be explored and which will lead you into a deeper knowledge of God. And I would suggest that all five of these avenues that I'm sharing with you here today should be traveled in your search of a knowledge of God. Just to recap, we have already spoken of finding God in nature and also in the historical accounts of the Bible. The next place you can find God is in the prophetic events of the Bible. Now, the fulfillment of these prophetic events can also be tied to history. But what makes the prophetic events different and a separate avenue of research is the fact that prophecy is something which is told before it happens. Many of these things just simply could not be known by man. They had to be spoken by an all-knowing God, a God who knows the end from the beginning, a God who guides the events of time and knows the course that humanity will trod. There are many prophecies in the Bible which display the foreknowledge, and the study of these will leave you utterly amazed at the accuracy of their exact fulfillment. There are prophecies which predict the rise and fall of successive nations, impacting the landscape of the world as we know it today. There are prophecies which predict local events in the lives of individual people. There are prophecies which predicted the exact time the Messiah would come, how long he would minister to humanity on this earth, and when he would give his life as our Savior. There are also prophecies concerning the setting up of God's kingdom here on this earth. Now, most prophecies have already been taking place with great accuracy. And when we see these having already been fulfilled, we are inspired with trust in God and believe in His Word that those prophecies yet to come will also be fulfilled exactly as He has predicted. The fourth avenue that a person can follow to gain a knowledge of God is in finding other people who themselves have already traveled these same roads. A person can gain much from talking to those whom have already had this personal experience with God. That's why it's so important as Christians to share one's faith with others. It is here where we can fill in the information that they need to find a deeper and more fulfilling knowledge of God in their own lives. This sharing of our faith, however, must also be accompanied by a life which has been transformed by the grace of God, a life which reflects the character of God and proclaims what God has done for you or for me, for us. Perhaps the most important avenue to gaining a knowledge of God is the fifth avenue, which I'm going to mention right now. This is the study of the story of redemption in the life of Jesus as found in the Holy Bible. The book Steps to Christ has this to say about the fifth avenue, and it's found on page 61. The theme of redemption is one that the angels desire to look into. It will be the science and the song of the redeemed throughout the ceaseless ages of eternity. Is it not worthy of careful thought and study now? The infinite mercy and love of Jesus, the sacrifice made in our behalf, call for the most serious and solemn reflection. We should dwell upon the character of our dear Redeemer and our intercessor. We should meditate upon the mission of Him who came to save His people from their sins. As we thus contemplate heavenly themes, our faith and love will grow stronger, and our prayers will be more and more acceptable to God, because they will be more and more mixed with faith and love. They will be intelligent and fervent. They will be more constant confidence in Jesus, and a daily living experience in His power to save to the uttermost all that come unto God by Him. As we meditate upon the perfections of the Savior, we shall desire to be wholly transformed and renewed in the image of His purity. There will be a hungering and a thirsting of soul to become like Him whom we adore. The more our thoughts are upon Christ, the more we shall speak of Him to others and represent Him to the world. As we just saw in this passage, the infinite mercy and love of Jesus, the sacrifice made on our behalf, call for the most serious and solemn reflection. I truly believe it's by traveling this avenue that a person will discover the riches of obtaining a knowledge of God, and where a person will find the strength and desire to travel the other avenues, leading to an even deeper understanding and knowledge of God. So then, my friends, I encourage every one of you who is searching for a knowledge of God to follow these five avenues with an open heart and an open mind. The promise of God in Jeremiah chapter 29 and verse 13 is, "And you shall seek me and find me, when you shall search for me with all of your heart." Yes, friend, if you search for God with all of your heart, you will find him. He will speak to your conscience and lead you along the pathway of life. Just to recap now, these five avenues once again are as follows. 1, the study of nature, leading you to see the fingerprints of God in his creation. 2, a study of biblical history, especially focusing on the miracles of the Bible and leading you into an understanding of the awesome power of God. Another is a study of the prophetic events of the Bible, proving that no matter how bad things may look or get, that God is still in control of the universe. A study, so to speak, in the movement of God in the lives of real people as you meet them in your daily search, learning how God has worked in and impacted their own life. And finally, and most importantly, a study of the redemption story, proving God's great love for you was manifested in the sacrifice of Jesus on the cross of Calvary, for your sins and for mine. A few words of wisdom in regards to reading the Bible are found in Steps to Christ, page 62, which says, "There is but little benefit derived from a hasty reading of the Scriptures. One may read the whole Bible through and yet fail to see its beauty or comprehend its deep and hidden meaning. One passage studied until its significance is clear to the mind and its relation to the plan of salvation is evident, is of more value than the perusal of many chapters with no definite purpose in view and no positive instruction gained. Keep your Bible with you. As you have opportunity, read it. Fix the texts in your memory. Even while you are walking the streets, you may read a passage and meditate upon it, thus fixing it in the mind. We cannot obtain wisdom without earnest attention and prayerful study. Some portions of Scripture are indeed too plain to be misunderstood, but there are others whose meaning does not lie on the surface to be seen at a glance. Scripture must be compared with Scripture. There must be careful research and prayerful reflection, and such study will be richly repaid, as the miner discovers veins of precious metal concealed beneath the surface of the earth. So will he who perseveringly searches the Word of God as for hid treasure, find truths of great value, which are concealed from the view of the careless seeker. The words of inspiration pondered in the heart will be as streams flowing from the fountain of life." So you see, my friends, it's vitally important that we come to the Bible with the right intentions, asking God in prayer to reveal himself to us as we study his holy word. I pray this program has helped to guide you in your thoughts and your plans to gain a deeper knowledge of God. In doing this, you will not only come to know him personally, but you will also continue to grow in him day by day. May God, according to his mercy and grace, grant you that which you need the most as you continue walking with Jesus.
Growing your walk with Jesus is very important. So we ask you to read your Bible each day and practice what you learn on a daily basis. Join us for our next program, where we will discuss how you can open your heart to God.